Good morning.
Good morning. Welcome.
Great to be here. Hello there. It's Sports This Morning. I'm Ayotunde Balogun. Welcome to the show right here on Channels Television. Well, today we'll be taking a look at the preparation of the under-23 male soccer team as Coach Samson Siasia shortlists some 31 players for the All Africa Games in Congo.
And also, we'll be talking about the Final Four, talking about the Federation's Cup. And, well, Enugu Rangers are actually on the verge, so to speak, of ending 31 years without a trophy. That's if they get to win the Federation Cup.
Let's wait and see if Enugu Rangers can do it. But we're still counting down to the start of the All African Games in Congo, Brazzaville. It's now 22 more days to go. How ready is Team Nigeria? Today on the show, we'll analyze boxing's preparations for that tournament that will kick off on September the 4th.
Quickly, we just can we talk a little bit about this Federation Cup?
But I'm shocked you're talking about Enugu Rangers when we've seen the biggest upset in women's football.
Okay, Rivers Angels, yeah, they can't be winning all the time.
Beating Rivers Angels.
Yeah, we know it was going to happen sometime. We know that. We're waiting for the time when is their winning streak going to end. You know, when you're looking at Rivers Angels, happens to be the most successful team when it comes to Federation Cup. But right now, they will not be there to defend this title. Wow. And another thing is, if you check, most of their players have actually left. Yeah. I know the distraction they had and all, they're preparing for the World Cup, All African Games and everything, teams going to camp and coming back. I think that's a whole lot of distraction for those
captain games. Leaving for...
Exactly. Most of them leaving the club. So at the end of the day, they're just trying to regroup and see how they can continue. But Conference Queens, I mean, they were really good. We'll give it to them. They were good on the day, and of course, they were able to ensure that where Rivers Angels, their dominance in the comes to Federation Cup is definitely over. But in the league, they're still unbeaten, so it's still there. They still have something to look forward to at the end of the season.
Mm-hmm. Guys, the All Africa Games football event, well, that is the one many Nigerians are really hoping that things will just click. And I use the word click for the team because, as you already know, the team is already in camp, preparing. The shortlist for the games has already been done by Coach Samson Siasia. So in the course of the show, we'll be bringing you some of them. Guys from some of the big clubs you'll expect, the likes of 3SC, the likes of Heartland, Ifeanyi Ubah, Enugu Rangers, Bayelsa United, some really great names in that list.
And I'm particularly excited because we've said it time and time again that Coach Samson Siasia is beginning to learn from the mistakes of the past. So now he's beginning to rely more on the home-based players, and I think that's the way to go. Instead of, going to look for players in Kazakhstan and Norway that might not be able to come in.
You have some foreign-based players in their team, but the question is, will they really be available when the tournament starts? But I think, just like what you said, it's better for him to really look at home and see the best players that can fit in and just try to pick the ones that really, really fit. I think for Coach Samson Siasia, it's All Africa Games. Come on, Nigeria can easily win the football title. I think they can do that.
With African football.
It's not that easy, but when you're focused and, of course, you know your players very well, of course, it's easy for you. Because if you check what Coach Samson Siasia has done, he was trying to rotate a team, and later he discovered that, your best bet is to have at least players that will be regular for the team, and that's what he has done. So when you have that, your regulars, you can decide to let me just invite two or three more players to blend with the regular that you have. But you're sure that your first 11 is always there. That's just the best way to go.
I think for this team, the vital quality they're beginning to have, and it's character.
Yeah.
The qualifying process has really put them
into
shape.
They just went there, did the job.
They had to be, focused, that's the word, and they got it done. It wasn't so straight in Port Harcourt, went to Pointe Noire, almost known as the Lions then in African football, and they didn't win, but they ensured that they also didn't concede. So it was really good for Coach Samson Siasia.
Master plan, I think that's a master plan.
So I think it's a good one for Nigeria. Go to the All Africa Games, win gold, just like we're expecting Cecilia Super Focus to also win gold.
Oh,
and then the big one, the African Championship before the Rio Olympics.
It's all about the All African Games, so that's for the football event, other sports as well, boxing, the trials and all of that. Yeah.
That's our own Olympics in Africa. It's our own Olympics is a way to bring the best of African athletes together, footballers, basketballers, volleyballers, boxers,
and tennis players,
table tennis players. It's another event that renews rivalries. In table tennis, it will be Nigeria against Egypt. In boxing, it will be Nigeria, North Africa, and even some parts of West Africa. In football, it's Nigeria against every other African country. So the African Games just gives our African sportsmen and women an opportunity to show the world that we've got talents right here in Africa.
Yeah, we've got it, and of course we can actually build on that at the world stage. Yeah, that's what we're looking at.
That's what we keep saying, but for Nigeria, it's another opportunity to say, hey, we're not just the giants of Africa, we can also rule in sports. That's why we've been doing this countdown, that's why I've been taking a look at their preparations with boxing. Mm. You know, sometimes when I look into the history of boxing in Nigeria, I just try to wonder how did we go wrong. Mm. Before independence, we already produced world champions. Ziggy Ekpa Tiger and Ogun Kebasi. We were so known,
the likes of Jericho Olympics,
Obisi Awakpa, even the current coach Tony Koyegwachi, they are champions in their right. So start asking.
Okay, recently we had Samuel Peters.
Recently you had Samuel Peters. Recently, how recent was it? And what happened? How did he
He was an heavyweight champion before, one of the Klitschko brothers decided to take it away from him.
Shegwa Adjose is a fantastic boxer. You know, if you go to the amateur rank, I get to speak a lot with some of the guys. We have talent in boxing. Again, guys, the same problem of infrastructure, the same problem of administration, same problem of boxers coming out with equipment. You go to the boxing gym just for box punching bags, one ring for over 350 boxers.
I think that's enough. We'll be taking a look at the papers first before you go into details, because I know you're very passionate about it.
How do we improve? How do we make the sports administrators?
They actually know how to do it.
In charge of boxing, really improve this, and I think they know what to do, but it takes a whole lot of willpower to make these changes.
I know, particularly with the All Africa Games, we were excited when the National Open Boxing Championship was done. Good one. If that championship had not come, Cecilia, maybe no competition would have even come out to hear the likes of Ifeotuba Akpochi, Kehinde Obare, Ademuyiwa, and the likes that we know, even Edith, Commonwealth bronze medalist. We've not heard about Edith since after the Commonwealth Games until the Open Championship. It's not a good one for these boxers. They need to get involved. Yes, they went to Cameroon, and after that, it's still Africa. What have you done? They missed out the World Championships.
But I think yesterday the trials was done. Yeah. How many boxers are going for the All Africa Games now?
About seven.
Just seven. I thought they said 13. No. What happened, Austin?
They organized the trials.
You were at the trials, so tell me what happened.
Okay. Coach Tony Koyegwachi will explain. Mm. You know, sometimes you just need to watch some boxers. You don't want to bring out the name so that people start feeling relaxed. You need to still keep them in cap, monitor them, and then. Maybe days to the game.
Okay, you count how many days now? 22 days. Okay, so they're just going to keep them until that's when we'll know. So how many are we going to be having? 7 or 13? 7.
13. Maybe 13.
But now it's 7. But the finalist right now is 7.
But right now, Coach Tony Koyegwachi told me he's certain of 7. Our viewers have an opportunity to meet two of the best boxers that will be going to that African Games. But still a lot of work to do. We'll just leave that to the boxers
joining us on the show. Okay, definitely. We'll be looking at the papers, of course. We'll just go for a short break now. Of course, Chinase Eboyin will be joining us, and we'll be looking at the papers, the big stories from the sports pages. Join us again.